Okay, so in this video, we are going to be looking at differentiation rules, doing examples on differentiation rules. We are going to start with the power rule. Okay, suppose you're given a function y is equal to x squared plus 3. So how would you derive this function using the power rule? So the power rule generally says that if you have y is equal to x to the power n, power, and then the derivative of that function dy over dx is going to be n multiplied by x to the power n minus 1. So that's what we are going to do here. Now dy over dx, the derivative of this function is going to be negative 2 x, because this is 2 times negative 1 there, 2 minus 1 plus. So if you look at this thing closely, you can see that when we have 3 here, we have x to the power 0. We can say that we have x to the power 0. So now if we have x to the power 0, we see that we are going to have 3 times 0 x to the power 0 minus 1. So this is going to be negative 2 x to the power 1, and therefore this is going to be plus 0. So we can see that whenever y is a constant, the derivative of a constant with respect to x or with respect to any variable, this is going to be 0. Okay, that was number one. Number two, y is equal to x squared plus x plus 8. Okay, so we can see that the derivative dy over dx of this function is going to be, this is going to be 2x plus, this is 1, so it's going to be 1 times x to the power 1 minus 1 plus 0, because 8 is a constant, which is going to be equal to 2x plus 1. Okay, and then let's proceed. S, let's do this one. S is equal to 5t to the power 3 minus 3t to the power 5. So ds over dt is going to be equal to 5 times 3, t to the power 3 minus 1, minus 3 times 5, t to the power 5 minus 1, which is going to be equal to 15 t squared minus 3 times 5. It's going to be 15 t to the power 4. Okay. For the example, let's say you have w equals to 3 z to the power 7 minus 7 times z to the power 3 plus 21 times z square. So it is going to be 3 times 7 x to the power 7 minus 1 minus 7 times, okay, this is 3 here. 7 times 3 times z to the power 3 minus 1. So I'm just showing you how this multiplies at the bottom. So 21 times 2 times z to the power 2 minus 1. So therefore, we are going to have 21x to the power 6 minus 21x to the power 2 plus 42 times z to power 1. Okay, if the example y is equal to 4 over 3 x to power 3 minus x plus 2 e to power x. So to do this one, you must know that the derivative of an exponential function, if we have y equals to e to the x, so dy over dx is just equals to e to power x. Therefore, the derivative of this function is going to be 4 over 3 times 3 x to the power 3 minus 1 minus the derivative of this function is going to be 1. Now we know that if we are deriving just x, a linear function x, you're going to get the coefficient that is next to x, the coefficient of x. Okay, so, and then when we are deriving this one, going to get plus 2 times e to the power x because e is retained in our differentiation. Whenever deriving d over dx of c times a certain function f of x, what we are going to get, c can be taken out, and then we have d over dx of f of x, which is going to be c f prime of x, like that. So that's why we can just ignore 2. We won't derive the number, we derive the function. Okay, let's look at the sixth example. In this example, y is equals to x to the power 3 over 3 plus x square over 2. Okay, plus e to the negative x. Now, dy over dx is going to be 3x to the power 3 minus 1 over 3 plus 2x to the power 2 minus 1 over 2. Now, when you're deriving this function, you're still going to get to chain rule, but if you're deriving d over dx of e to the negative x, that's going to be negative e to the negative x. But we're still going to talk about that when we are speaking about chain rule. So this is minus e to the negative x. Therefore, we can just write it and say this is x squared plus x minus e to the negative x. Okay, let's look at the seventh example. W equals to 3 z to the negative 2 minus z to the negative 1. So dw over dz is equal to 3 times negative 2 z to the negative 2 minus 1 minus negative 1 times z to the negative 1 minus 1, which is going to be negative 6 z to the negative 3 plus z to the negative 2. And we're always multiplying with the exponent, with the coefficient. Exponent, the coefficient, and minus 1. Okay, this is our derivative. And then let's do the eighth one. S is equals to negative 2 t to the power negative 1 plus 4 t to the negative 2. Okay, ds over dt, that's going to be negative 2 times the exponent minus 1 to the exponent plus 4 times the exponent to t to the negative 2 minus 1. That's going to be positive 2 t to the negative 2 minus 8 t to the negative 3, which is going to be equal to 2 over t squared minus 8 over t cubed. Look at another example. Y equals to 6x squared minus 10x minus 5x to the power negative 2. Okay, that's going to be dy over dx is going to be 6 times 2x to the power 2 minus 1 minus 10 minus 5 times negative 2 x to the power negative 2 minus 1 is going to be 12 x to the power 1 minus 10 plus 10 x to the power negative 3. Okay, let's look at another example. So we have r equals to 1 over 3 s power negative 2 minus 5 over 2 s to the negative 1. So for this one, dr over ds is equals to 1 over 3 times negative 2, the exponent, s to the power negative 2 minus 1 minus 5 over 2 times the exponent s to the power negative 1 minus 1. It is negative 2 over 3 s to the power negative 3. S to the power negative 3 minus 5 over 2 s to the power negative 2. Okay, that's it about examples on power rule. Now let's try and look examples involving product rule. So product rule says that if we have a product rule, says that if you have a function f of x, which is a product of two functions, a derivative d over dx of f of x is going to be equal to g prime of x, you derive the first one first, and then plus derive this other one, and then multiplied by g of x. So this is how you product rule works. Let's see an example of this. So we have y is equal to 3 minus x squared times x cubed minus x plus 1. So in a function like this, you can see that this could be our f of x and this could be our g of x. So you can see that we could just distribute this, but you can use product rule because this is a function and this is a function. Now y prime or dy over dx is going to be the derivative of this function, which is going to be negative 2x because the derivative of constant is 0. And then you just put back this one, we don't derive it, and then we derive again the function, this we leave this one, and then we derive the other one. So here the derivative is going to be 3x squared minus 1. Okay, so you can see that you power rule to be able to use product rule, and you can distribute and say, but there's no need, we just showed how to do power rule in this example. Let's do another example. Okay, this was the first example. Do a second example. The second example, we have y equals to x squared plus 1 x plus 5 plus 1 over x. Okay, again we can see that we have a function f of x and we have a function g of x, so we can then derive and say, okay, now d over dx is going to be the derivative of this function, which is going to be 2x, and then just put back this one, don't derive it, and then put this one now and derive the other one. So the derivative of this is going to be x. No, it's not going to be x, it's going to be 1 because the derivative is going to be 1 plus derivative of constant is 0, and then x, this is equals to like that, power negative 1. So therefore the derivative of this is going to be negative x to the negative 2, like that. Okay, therefore we are done with differentiation. You can just expand if you like, x squared plus 10x plus 2 plus this is x squared, this is going to be x squared minus 1 plus 1 minus x to the negative 2, which is going to be 3x squared plus 10x plus 2 minus x to the negative 2. Okay, let's do a third one. So we have y is equal to 1 plus x squared bracket x to power 3 over 4 minus x to power negative 3. So this is f, this is g. So we can use product rule and say d over dx. That's going to be 0 plus 2x and put back this one as it is, and then derive this one, which is going to be 3 over 4 x to the power 3 over 4 minus 1 minus, okay, negative 3 here, negative 3 minus 1 times this one. Okay, so you can then multiply if you like, but there is no need. You've just showed how to do product rule, but we can then simplify further and say this is going to be 2x to the power 3 over 4 plus 1 minus x to the power 2x to the power negative 2 plus, there is going to be 3 over 4 x to the power negative 1 over 4 minus 3 times x to the power negative 4, 1 plus x squared. Okay, no need to continue with this question and expanding, but because we've shown how to use product rule, that's what is important for this question. Okay, so now let us do another example on this. So the example that we're going to be doing is an example. So, okay, for y is equal to square root of x cubed times x squared plus 1 over x cubed. Okay, so you can see that you have a product of two functions again. So we have f and g. So we can write this as x to the power 3 over 2, because we know the square root of x cubed, that's 3 over 2, times x squared plus x to the negative 3. Okay, this is our y. Therefore, dy over dx is going to be 3 over 2 x to the power 3 over 2 minus 1, and then we put back this one. And we write this one and derive the other one. So this is going to be 2x minus 3x to the negative 3 minus 1. That's going to be 3 over 2x to the power negative 1 over 2. Yes. Nope. That's negative, positive. Times x squared plus x to the negative 3 plus x to the power 3 over 2, 2x minus 3, x to the negative 4. Okay. Let's do another example in product rule. This one is going to be example number 5. So y is equals to, let's do this one, let's do 1 over cube root of x squared minus 1 over 4th root of x cubed. This is multiplied by e to the power x plus x. Again, we have a product of two functions, so let us first write it in exponential form. So this is going to be x to the power negative 2 over 3 minus x to the power negative 4 over 3 e to the power x plus x, and then let us derive the function. Negative 2 over 3 x to the negative 2 over 3 minus 1 minus x negative, okay, negative 4 over 3 here. Negative 4 over 3 minus 1 times e to the power x plus x plus the derivative of this, this is going to be e to the power x plus 1 times x to the negative 2 over 3 minus x to the negative 4 over 3. Okay, that's how we do product rule. Those were the examples. So let's look at the quotient rule. Quotient rule. So just to recap, the quotient rule says if you have a function f of x equals to h of x over g of x. So f prime of x, the derivative, is going to be equals to g of x times h prime of x minus h prime of h of x times g prime of x over g of x squared. So this is what the rule is saying. Okay, we're going to just follow that and do examples. Now, okay, so we have y equals to 2x plus 5 over 3x minus 2. So therefore, dy over dx of this function. So you can see that this is f of x and this is g of x. So the derivative of this function is going to be 3x minus 2 times the derivative of that, which is 2, minus, derive this one now, 3 times 2x plus 5 all over 3x minus 2 all squared. Okay, so the 6x minus 4 minus 6x minus 15 over 3x minus 2 all squared. So that's going to be 6x cancels 6x, and that's going to be negative 19 over 3x minus 2 all squared. Okay, let's do another example. It's going to be y is equals to 4 minus 3x all over 3x squared plus x. So dy over dx, so you can see that this is our f, or this is our, this is the function and this is a function. So derive this one and leave the other one. So you can just write this one and then derive the other one. That's going to be negative 3 using power rule, minus, derive this one. Now it's going to be 6x plus 1, and just write the other one. So it's a very simple trick of deriving and write squared on the denominator. Okay. You can further simplify this function, but there is no need for us to do so, since we have shown how to do quotient rule. Okay, so I think we are in a position to do another example. So this was example number one, example number two. So this is going to be example number three. So let's say you have f of t equals to t squared minus 1 over t squared plus t minus 2. So we can then say f prime of t is going to be t squared plus t minus 2 times 2t minus 0. Okay, minus t squared minus 1, and derive the other one, which is going to be t squared 2t, okay, 2t plus 1 all over t squared plus t minus 2 all squared. Okay, then you can further simplify this. But you have now seen how to derive using this method. So x of plus 5 power 2x plus minus 7. So let's look at this example using quotient rule. So dw over dx is going to be place this. So it's a very simple trick. Times 1, because the derivative of this is 1, minus the derivative of this one is going to be 2 times x plus 5 all over 2x minus 7 all squared. So now you can further simplify because this won't be too much work. X 2x minus 10 all over 2x minus 7 squared. 2x cancels 2x, negative 17 over 2x minus 7 squared. Okay.